the two most used softwares today are Capture One by Phase One and Adobe Lightroom. When it comes to capturing files while shooting tethered to a computer, Capture One is a clear winner as of today. Lightroom can do the same things, but Capture One does it faster. What takes Capture One a second may take Lightroom around 6 to 8 seconds with the same computer or camera setup. So if you shoot a series of images with color corrections applied, Lightroom will take forever to catch up. There's a lot of debate regarding skin tones. Some say they love the skin color Capture One produces, while others prefer Lightroom. The truth is, Capture One can be really great with some camera profiles, but quite off with the others. Lightroom, on the other hand, does equal justice to all cameras producing average but consistent colors. For example, take a look at this image shot on a Phase One digital back. Right now, we are in Capture One, and as you can see, this image is unedited. And here is the same unedited image in Lightroom. Not much of a difference, right? Let's go to this image shot on a Nikon D5100. And here is the same unedited image in Capture One. As you can see, the colors are way off. So if you happen to own a camera for which Phase One has designed a profile with the same dedication as for this Nikon camera, you would obviously lean towards Lightroom colors. There is a workaround though. You can try testing other camera profiles which works better with your camera, and in this case, the Nikon D810 generic profile gives me a much better starting point. Capture One also has a fully featured color editor compared to Lightroom, but the one tool that is simply amazing is the skin editor tool. Let me give you a quick demo on this image. Taking this eyedropper tool, I'll select the mid-tone of the skin. By checking this box here, you can preview the selected area. I'm going to narrow down the color selection by making this slice thinner and shorter. Next, I'll bring down the smoothness slider, which reduces the feathering of the skin selection. Now that I have the desired skin area selected, I'm going to uncheck the preview box. Now I'm going to increase these uniformity sliders, which will balance out the hue, saturation, and lightness across the skin. And this results in a much even skin tone. You can even fine-tune the skin further with the hue and saturation sliders. Let me show you the before and after. These skin improvements and further color grading can be applied on the fly when you're shooting tethered, making Capture One the most preferred capture software. When it comes to raw conversions and workflow with Photoshop, Lightroom shines. When professionals convert raw images for any important or high-end work, it is always done in multiple conversions of the same file, as one file simply can't show all that data without some masking technique. And yes, Capture One and Lightroom both have masking and adjustment tools and layers, but Photoshop is simply smoother, faster, and gives you pixel-level accuracy in real time. The most common workflow to make these conversions in Capture One and Lightroom is to create duplicates, which are called variants in Capture One, and in Lightroom, they are called virtual copies. So suppose you want to make adjustments for the highlights in the first one, and shadows in the other, and now you're ready to edit them in Photoshop. So you select these two variants in Capture One, right click, and edit in Photoshop. And Capture One will save these files on the hard drive first, then open them one by one in Photoshop. And in Lightroom, when you right-click the images and go to Edit In, you will find an option that will open these images as layers in Photoshop. This is much more convenient than the Capture One workflow, especially if you have more than two files. Now, there's one other workflow which is far more flexible and faster and involves something called Smart Objects. So far, we are just halfway through the raw conversion. In the next episode, I'll take you over some really cool blending techniques in Photoshop, so stay tuned for that.